2K18 my career. Just finished working out, so now I'm going to go to the game.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show. Hello, basketball fans. I'm Ernie Johnson, welcoming you to 2K Sports. I'm here with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Tonight, it'll be the Portland Trail Blazers up against the San Antonio Spurs. Well, for San Antonio, they split the season series against these guys last season, 2 games apiece. Should be a good one tonight. Hey, a chance now to watch CJ McCollum in action. Definitely one of the sharpshooters in the league. But you don't often hear his name mentioned among the elite. You guys feel like he may be underrated as a shooter?
I think he's definitely underrated. He's as dead-eye as most players in the league. Incredible percentages from the floor and from beyond the arc. This guy can shoot the ball.
What probably people forget about is the fact that he can get to the rim so easily. That's why they don't pay attention to the dead-eye shooting. But he's a dead-eye shooter. Tie check?
Yeah.
Okay.
That was an audible yawn we heard from that side of the set. What gives?
Because I'm dead-eye tired.
Okay.
Whatever.
No, that was good.
Kevin Harlan. He understands everything. And he's standing by with the ball. Next.
It was at 8-20 donuts. Just got some new gear from Adidas because Adidas is thinking about sponsoring me, so they sent me some new shoes. Check them out right now. See which ones I'm gonna wear. So pretty nice. Let's go to the game. Walk to the court.
What's going on, boo-boo? It's
my sister calling. She knows we're in town.
So pick it up, man. She probably misses you.
Shh. Borrow another $500.
Don't mind your business and play your game. I got this.
Sounds like my family right there, like a mother.
Hey, sis.
What? They actually showed the security guard this time? And they showed me running out? What?
Right in the middle of the standings will not make things easy for them down the stretch. Well, Blazers head coach Terry Stotts is one of the more respected offensive minds in the game. He said, I like to give our players freedom to read the defense and make plays. I like philosophically that I don't know who's going to get the shot. That's going to cause a problem for the defense. Keep them guessing, Kevin.
And as always, thanks, D. That kind of unpredictability helps in some settings can cause any matchup problems for the D. Well, as we go deeper into the season, we see some teams, Chris, really start to shuffle things around with injuries. And what's it like playing on a team that is dealing with a lot of players that are injured?
It's frustrating. You don't know how much confidence to have in your team. You don't know what to believe in, what not to believe in. Rehabilitation is one of the most frustrating parts of playing the game. You just continue to do the same thing every day. You start to feel kind of disconnected from your team, and you kind of start feeling down and bad. And so that feeling can become contagious on a team with injuries, because you really honestly know that there's nothing else you can do but wait to heal. And so that's really frustrating. So being on a team with a lot of players injured, it's just frustrating. The only thing you can do is to encourage those players that are getting playing time and use this time to improve their game, so that when everyone does come back, hopefully some good will come out of it.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. On the court right now for the Spurs, Aldridge and Kawhi Leonard, the two stars at the forward spots. Parker and Green are the guard set. And it's Gasol and at the back spot. Nurkic. And it's sent back by Aldridge. Turner against Leonard. Shoots over Turner, and that one's good. Leonard.
And he's got the athleticism and strength to be a powerful presence inside. Leonard never afraid to get in and mix it up down low.
Here's Collins, currently averaging almost 6 points a game. There's the pick. And Lillard picks to McCollum. Five on the clock. Over Green. There's Nurkic. And it's sent back by Aldridge.
Not getting anything to fall here early. Four straight misses to start the game.
Good work there as it goes.
Yeah, and that's what you want from
the All right, let me jump in now.
The new group here for Portland. Davis is checked in for Nurkic. Reese Harkless comes in for Collins. Pat Connaughton, he's checked in for Evan Turner. And Shabazz Napier subbed in for Damian Lillard. So San Antonio going with an almost entirely new group here. Rudy Gay's checked in for Gasol. DJ comes in for Leonard. Anna Ginobili's checked in for Green. Chris Mills in for Parker.
And setting the tone early with a strong move to the rack.
Well, you like to see a little more physical nature on defense. You have to make him earn those points at the strike.
Here's DJ, and plenty of contact on the shot. So, two free throws coming up. And there's the call, Portland the foul.
I like the attitude of that. It's a quiet player who makes his presence felt on both ends of the court.
It's his first trip to the line.
He struggled mightily at the free throw line in their last game.
He's on shit.
In the Spurs last season.
My bad, coach.
Winning seasons with 20. This is a group that's won 50 or more games in every one of those seasons, except the strike shortened one in 99.
McCollum gets to Donovan. Trailblazers moving the ball around. Davis sets a sprint. McCollum outside. Dishes it to Napier. The Trailblazers need to get off a shot.
DJ is a strong, rangy defender. He excels at being a pest and annoying whoever he's on.
Game with it. Guarded now by Harkless. Kicks to Mills. Now, here's DJ. He's tightly guarded. On target from 13 feet.
And how's that? Core move, a killer crossover. It's a thing of beauty.
36 seconds left in the first. Paper kicks to Connaughton. Davis sets a screen. At the top of the key, Napier lets the three fly. Hit the put down. Davis on the follow.
Yeah, they got that one, but early on, it's really been a struggle for them to secure that defensive backboard.
Here's Mills. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Offensive rebound. There's the dish to DJ. Shoots a three. No good that time. McCollum.
That was supposed to go in, man.
Trailblazers lead by one. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in just a moment. And the Gasol brothers, Powell, talked about the joy of sharing the NBA stage with his brother Mark.
It's like a dream come true. I can really picture it. I'm just proud to be Mark's brother, and I'm proud to what he's become as a basketball player and as a man.
Well, their story is a bit like a fairy tale, the way two of them, sons of medical professionals in Spain, have become two of the best centers in the NBA at this age.
Especially when you remember what a raw talent and how big and bulky Mark Gasol was when he was drafted by the Lakers. I mean, they traded him to Memphis for his brother, and that does all seem like fiction, doesn't it?
And so far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter up and going. And taking a look at the Trail Blazers' performance here, boys, what do you think they're doing or not doing?
I tell you what, that first quarter, you can see the game plan is a commitment to offensive rebounding.
Oh, yeah, this is how they squeezed out extra possession and captured the early
lead. Davis is out there with no help. Then there's McCollum, and he's in the three slots. That's the group of the game for the Trail Blazers. And that one misses. And Chris, power forwards today shoot a lot more three-pointers. If you played today, I think you'd be incredibly effective in that role. How do you think you'd be in that role?
Oh, yeah, I think that that's something I would definitely have fun and relished in. I did shoot threes a couple of seasons in Washington and was pretty successful at that, but the style of play was just so different then. Big men were asked to stay in the post, and there's a lot more work in the post, a lot more pressure on the big guy to get to the free throw line to wear down the defense. So the whole game was different then. The big man kind of ruled the game. Today it's a point guard's game, and so what's great is I'd have to step out to give the point guard a lot more room to drive, take a shot blocker away, or because there aren't any shot blockers. And so I definitely would love to hang out in that corner and shoot that easy three or at the top after a pick and roll. Back. That would have been a lot of fun, especially to give him freedom, because you can shoot that Jimmy like that, get a nice little jump shot, and allow that pump fake to work today. So I would have pump fake a lot of people from the front line and dunk on a lot of people. So that would have been fun to have that freedom as they do today. Just like it's fun watching these guys let it fly from that three.
Ginobili with the ball, now defended by McCollum. Day can't hit.
You can see the defender's afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Spurs trail by three. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldrin.
Thanks, Kevin. Hey, the Portland Trail Blazers are developing a great chemistry for a young team. Damian Lillard takes the team to San Diego every September for bonding purposes. And he told me how much we like each other, how much time we spend around each other. That shows you a team that is really together. It is a unit. We have each other's back. Kevin?
And it's critical to establish camaraderie early on. Thank you, D.A. Sounds like Lillard has this team headed in the right direction. Here's Hernandez. Can't hit that one. Now Portland takes it the other way. And this matchup with the Spurs, it's their first meeting of the season.
The game is the first of a three-game season series for these clubs, both looking to take round one. Yeah, and they play in the same conference. Not a rivalry per se, but familiar enough to cause some tricky problems for one another. Well, check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates that are clearly on the same page.
Well, the Blazers' offense is based on flow and movement. A lot of screens off the ball creating openings for the shooters.
Davis sets a screen. Connaughton kicks to McCollum. Again, McCollum missing.
He just looked lost on offense, but luckily for him, his teammates have really stepped up in a big way.
Here's DJ. Uses the glass to finish the layup. DJ's got eight.
He played a very solid first quarter, and now he's taking it up a notch here in the second.
Now a timeout called by... And the Blazers are the better offensive teams in the league. They and predictable.
Well, they keep the defense moving and reacting. The weak side occupied.
So far, so good. So far, so good.
Isolation. Lately, really unbelievable.
Man, this is a joke. I mean, there have been some glimpses of hope, but they've been few and far between.
As we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Kevin, thanks. Here with Coach Terry Stotts. Coach, it's a hard game so far. Going into the second half, what will you tell your team?
You just got to compete. You know, keep competing, trust each other, and make plays.
All right, Coach, thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, Dave, thank you. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow. Right here on 2K Sports. The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Really making a difference here.
Yeah, I mean, he really gave them a boost in that first half. Shot way above his average.
Oh, this is like foul money. Completely unexpected, but it feels great when it happens.
On the court right now for the Spurs, the defensive tandem of Green and Leonard.
I definitely jumped back. Aw, damn.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs. Portland shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night. And team free throw numbers really about as good as you could ask for. Around 80% on the season.
That one drops. He ties it up. And Nurkic, the first player, Chris, in over 30 years to record a game with 28 points, 20 rebounds, 8 assists, and 6 blocks.
Yeah, he lit up the Sixers that night in the win for the Blazers. His hot start ignited Nurkic fever in Portland and helped propel them back into that playoff run.
Now the free throw is good, now leading by one. The Spurs shooting for the game at 42%. Parker kicks to Aldridge.
Let's go.
Ed Davis has checked in for Collins. Reese Harkless comes in for Evan Turner. Pat Connaughton is checked in for C.J. McCollum. And it's Napier in for Damian Lillard. San Antonio also making some changes. Bertanis, he's checked in for Gasol. D.J. comes in for Leonard. And Rudy Gay is subbed in for Danny Green. Guys, we're not through three quarters of play, but 6 lead changes already in this one.
Yeah, competitive, and I think we all can agree that we thought this would be the type of game that would come down to the end.
Davis sets a screen. Nurkic a screen on Parker. Napier kicks to Davis. Nurkic against Aldridge. To Connaughton, who's back up, and that one falls coming off of Davis's speed, and the Trailblazers lead by one. Parker dishes to Aldridge. Aldridge is screen. Here's Hernandez. Here's Pertinis. An easy layup after coming off the pick.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
Davis sets a screen. Here's Harkless. Bertans grabs the board.
I think a kick out is the better option. Defense had the rim on lockdown.
Here's Aldridge. Another shot. And DJ with a layup. DJ's got 10 points.
Yeah, 3 consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The D had better start. Buckley now.
Davis kicks to Nathan. Feeds to Harkless from deep. And it's Gay with the rebound. Spurs leading by 3. Dishes it to DJ. And the rebound by Nurkic. Nurkic has got rebound 3 on the night. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Napier passes to Harkless. He feeds it to Nurkic. A baseline J. Bounces high off the rim and drops. He's got 10. And we just finished the third quarter. We got a tight ball game here. Spurs lead by 1. From Portland, we're back in a moment. Terry Stotts had some advice for his team. Let's hear what he had to say.
Right now, we're playing 10. We're backing down, throwing soft passes, and getting us in the hole.
Typically a measured guy in this approach. Jerry Stotts trying to turn up the heat on his guys.
And that's because he knows when his team is attacking, that's when they're able to go on those runs.
Thanks for joining us again as we get set for the fourth quarter. A terrific game so far. The forwards are Evans and Collins. Napier is out there with McCollum, and it's Davis in the pivot spot manning the middle. That's the group on the floor for Portland.
Yeah.
Pau Gasol is checking for LaMarcus Aldridge.
Pop don't look happy.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
One shot. Gotta make it count. Here we go. One shot, one shot.
Bet. DJ. And Damian Lillard said he's committed to finishing his career in Portland. Title or not, he's invested in this franchise.
Now, team first, though. That helps all the players. And new additions have to fall in line with example he set. He said the culture won't change because he won't allow it to happen.
San Antonio leading by four. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
But with DJs on the attack, watch out. Sometimes all you can do is whack him. Hope he misses it. Terrific speed.
Okay. Almost made it down. Coach is like, really? Like, Popovich is like, okay.
Two shots.
Spurs making a switch here. Leonard's checked in. Good on the second.
Bet.
Yeah, the main thing here, though, guys, is just to make sure you get a two-possession game.
Trailblazers trail by five. Make your dishes to McCollum. Outside Leonard. A little over a minute of the fourth quarter gone right now. And for Portland, they're shooting only 32% from the field. Plenty of signs of struggle by this offense today. Here's the feed to Napier. Davis sets a screen. Napier kicks to Davis. McCollum outside. Gasol sends it back. Just over a minute and a half play here in the fourth. Parker, terrific.
Good shit.
And a big play, and he lays it in. And the Spurs lead by seven.
I'm sorry, that's poor defense down low again. It's been a mismatch thus far in the paint.
Here's Napier, covered by Parker. Davis sets a screen. Here's Napier. Rebound San Antonio. Gasol's got his third rebound on the night. Nobody near Leonard. And it's Leonard again missing.
He's got to be wondering how he missed that. I mean, he had all the space in the world.
Turner with the screen. Back to McCollum. And the rebound by Leonard.
In a sensational individual defender. Leonard will lock you down. Rejections are just part of the package he brings on the defensive end.
Here's Napier, covered by Parker. Here's Napier, McCollum outside.
Well, if they want to cut into this lead, they need to make more intelligent plays on offense and not force something up when it's not there.
And that one's good.
Yeah, Parker's ability to stretch it, it really forces the defense to contest it from out there.
Now a timeout called by Portland.
Yeah! We ready! We ready! Come on! Yeah! We ready! And speak to me. And yeah, we reckon.
and our Jordan player of the game, Pau Gasol.
What?
And he's up over 50% from the field.
How do you give it to Pau Gasol when he only have 5 points? Dude. That is bullcrap, man. Bitch, that's probably going to beat him to the end of the game, too. What'd I say?
This is a hard-fought, well-earned victory for him, Greg. They really had to work for this win.
That's a good point. I mean, weaker teams might have buffered some bad.
I tried to find the spaces and the gaps that they may be slow to cover. So when we have the ball moving around like the team did today, it's easy to stay in a rhythm and see plenty of shots. And tonight I was able to convert.
The ball really was moving. Congrats on the win. Back to you guys.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Chris Weber, Greg Anthony, and David Olton. This is Kevin
Harlan. They show me walking back now, too? Yeah. Number 8, nigga. Yeah, my favorite number.
Hey, Boo Boo. What's up? What'd you think of that?
Think of what?
Come on.
Oh. I got a job to do, man. You can't expect me to watch every game. I'm just playing with you, man. Of course I'll watch this.
Hey.
DJ Big Time. That's who you are. DJ Big Time.
Man.
Man. You out there killing it.
Yeah. Let's go ahead and head out. So what do y'all think about that game? I think that was a pretty good game. It's probably one of the best games I've played so far with my in my career on my creative guy. Well, not my, technically, I guess you could say created. But I think that was pretty good. We have like 13, 15 points, so many rebounds, like 10, 12 points in the paint. I mean, what's wrecking? Percent still, dang, slow for some reason today. Back to the streets. This workout on and smash this next game. Yeah, and I'm finna get it. And later on, I'll probably release some tracks of my stumbling back there, stumbling, but get it, boy, get it. Come on, come on, come on. Get it, son, get it. Come on, come on. Oh, just slow it. Come on, come on, get it, get it. Keep a positive mind, but positive vibe. Ain't nothing going on around my life. Yeah. Let me get it now, finish message beep, and the gator, cause I'm a beast. Reckon NBA so clean, man, don't even give me get it. My boy only 67, and he smashing like that, but was ranked number 97. And I'm wrecking on this, cause I'm so fresh on this, and I'm repping on this while I'm playing on this. And I still smash on this bitch while I'm wrecking on this mic. Now let me focus. Yeah, what for lunch? How about the next opponent? Ain't no stressing, cause I'm already on it. Study getting better as the day goes on. Study getting better as the day goes on. Yeah. 100%, let's go. Now let's upgrade a little bit. Do what I want, smashing on the track, cause I steady do what I want. Shine forever, might as well shine together. Straight smashing. Oh, I missed it. Don't. a.m. What the hell are we waiting on? The fuck? Oh, that's bullshit, yo. NBA 2K, you wrong for that motherfucker. Oh, that's not some straight bitch ass shit, yo. Cowboy did that, yo. Damn it. Is that funny? Oh, what, did a backflip like that? Like that, bro? I hope I end up taking any tickies. Take off my headphone. Yeah, let's get it.
Yo. Yo, hello?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah. That sound your sounds.
Yeah.
You guys hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah.
Oh, good blood. I don't know what they're happening there.
Get the fuck out of my house.
From Oz.
Ah. Here's a sharpshooter, that guy right there. Oh, good shit. If you would have did that, I would have blocked it either way. Go ahead, that's you, that's you.
Bro. Wait,
can you shoot?
Oh, fuck.
Oh, what the fuck?
Energy.
Yeah.
Energy rock.
Practice.
Yo, man.
Yeah.
Are you talking on a police scanner?
Yo. No, it's this guy.
It's this game shot, practice.
Get the fuck out of my house. Oh.
Ah.
Okay.
Oh, I finished. It's your screen.
Cut.
Oh,
man.
I know. That was a perfect opportunity. I missed it.
If I would have tried to dunk it, he would have macked it.
Yeah, when you got Brackus full on your team, right? Man.
Well, I don't know what that means.
You get
oh, you mean like 2-3? Is that what you're trying to say? Like a 2-3? Or a 1-2, I guess?
I did fucking best right now.
Oh.
I feel like you can shoot that deep shot. I don't know.
Ah, I jumped too soon.
Can you shoot? No, you can't.
He could sure dunk. He could sure dunk though.
Hold up. I'm gonna draw your man into me, and then I'm gonna find you.
Yeah, like right there.
Oh my god.
I suck. Like, I just put on Tyree Gavins and base 11. And I took off my phone and game show. And I'm not good with it at all, bro. I'm just behind.
Go, I got your screen down here. Oh. Ah.
Oh, that's fine.
Don't come in here. Oh, what the hell? Ah, he was too strong.
Shit.
Ooh, nice.
See you, bro.
Ah. Damn it! I was just trying to do too much, trying to get at least one in.
We have a robbery problem.
Yeah, it's because I'm talking to my headphones. My new ones I got. See, I can make it sound like a scanner too, because I know how to do little funny sounds and shit. Oh, you thought I was going to leave you alone? Damn, we both jumped. Ah, he should have took off. A good shot though, still went in.
Give me that shit.
Oh, he sure did that. I thought he was gonna keep going. Oh, how the hell you still make that shit? Yeah. What, smacking me all up in the face and shit? Trying to reach through the ball, boy said, "Sah!" Straight smack my head. Bam, bam. Oh, shit. Bet I wanted to guard Cowboy too. Come on, Cowboy. Where you going, bitch? Where you going, bitch? Play that D on that boy. Stop doing one time. Watch it. Oh, shit.
No.
Ah! Oh. I didn't think he was gonna shoot that shit. Dang.
I didn't think you'd hit it. I kinda made it in time.
That's a good game, though. Cancel the video. Yeah, they're talking about me.
How can you sit him on a bench?
Yeah, for real. Come on, Popovich, you tripping, bro.
Ready in his last few games. I think this is a coaching error. This guy is ready, and if you don't play him, you could find yourself without a job.
And not only that, as a player, you don't ever want to hand your starting job to another guy. But hey, Kenny, like I said, DJ has earned it. And I think the coach is smart enough to make this decision really, really quick.
Were you guys around the other day when DJ was walking around here in the studio?
Oh, without question.
Yeah, I saw it.
He's taller than I thought he was.
Yeah, he was. Very personable, very nice guy.
He didn't have an entourage. I like that.
I like that too.
Oh, I know. Well, maybe he can borrow yours.
Well, I don't have an entourage.
He left his bag in there, and then it was just full with money. I mean, DJ's get paid.
Yeah, and I almost took it, but
I said, we gave it back.
Oh, damn, I did all that? God damn, DJ, you tripping, bro. Losing shit in real life, losing shit in the game. That's funny, they're giving me compliments and shit. That's just it. And this feels like a victory. I'm so fresh and clean. Finna get it, you feel what I mean? Check out my closet. Keep them bad boys. Let's go. Head to the coat. Fucking shot ain't on. Ooh, nice shot, DeJounte. Bang, Kawhi with the yam. Ooh, clean no look bad. Oh. Minnesota 26-6.
Kevin, I think this is where having a great leadership and veteran
starting yet. Hopefully, maybe a good game today will give me a starting job.
Simon Damian, one guy, and I'm still blocking my guy, and it won't be somebody else. Come on, man.
Pass to Aldridge. Here's TJ. Once again, off the mark by San
Fuck,
Antonio.
Man, what the hell?
It's the Jazz's ball. A nice run going 12 in a row. Crowder kicks to Rubio. Nice ball movement by Utah. Dishes it to Udo. Back to Sevalosha. Udo, the pass to Burks. Here's Rubio, rebounded by the Spurs, fresh from a win against Portland.
Just a terrific effort off the bench. Guys came in, they seemed fresh, and they all contributed.
I think, Greg, everyone played their role so well, and I loved how aggressive the guys on the bench were in that one. That's a big payoff for crashing the offensive boards. Go to work.
The Spurs shooting their first foul shot of the night, and that one falls for LaMarcus. Outside. And he makes that one.
Come on, man. Let's put a hand up something, bro. Don't worry, I'll bring it back.
It's the Jazz as as they end the first quarter on a 14-3 run, and we'll return shortly. Favors known for his work ethic, and he talked about his focus on developing his skills.
I just want to get better. I just want to keep improving as a player throughout the year, just get better, keep making strides, and keep being better in every aspect of my game.
Well, Sires there, and sounds like the commitment that he's showing is to how far, Greg, you think he can go?
Well, you talk about desire and commitment, and then you throw in the fact that he has the talent that can be built upon and improved. One big factor will be injuries. That's the big X factor that determines so many more careers than desire. Talent and commitment, you need to stay on the court.
Well, not exactly a close game so far, but as the second quarter starts here, plenty of time for a comeback. What do you guys think about the Jazz here in this one?
I mean, an interesting first quarter. The pressure D seems to be causing a lot of turnover.
Feels like they're getting a lot of deflections, hands on basketballs, resulting into steals. This has been pretty to watch.
On the court for San Antonio here in the second, Mills and Manu at the guards. Anderson is out there with Rudy Gay, and it's DJ in at the small forward position. On the sideline, let's get Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, the Spurs have never been the flashy team in the NBA. Tony Parker said beautiful basketball is playing the right way. Ball movement, pure, beautiful basketball is the way we've played. We have all sorts of fans, and there should be something for everybody. Kevin, he told me a long time ago, if we were in New York, people would love us.
And during Popovich's time in San Antonio, the Spurs have always played together, D.A. Got to respect their team-first approach to the game. Of course, you talk about versatility of players, but as a broadcaster, been a courtside reporter, game analyst, studio host, you name it, what do you prefer to do? What do you like most?
There's no question about it, Kev. The analyst role is the absolute most fun. Now, the only thing that might push that over the top is inside the great Kevin Harlan.
In the NBA, and it was nice to see them back in the playoffs in 2017 after that four-year rebuilding phase. It tied their longest playoff drought since the team moved to Utah.
Here's what Utah's going with right now. Rudy Gobert, he's checked in for Utah. Yurepko comes in for Crowder, and it's Mitchell in for Ricky Rubio. And this Jazz organization operating in a small market, but over the years, so competitive.
Yeah, you know, and a lot of times teams want to take shortcuts. But the Jazz know they're not going to win the free agent bidding wars, and that creates a kind of discipline that they're looking to build from within.
Four on the shot clock. Here's Mitchell. Can't hit the step back jump shot.
Boy, terrific defense to impact the shot, not giving him any space at all.
Offensive rebound, Anderson. Gobert with the block, and he gets it back. And Anderson gets it to go. And we're about 2 minutes into the second quarter. Mitchell dishes to Yurepko. And there's the pass to Mitchell. And it's Yurepko, top of the key. Hurts on the wing, covered by Parker. Shot to stop the drought. A rebound by the Spurs. After this one, they're off to Sacramento to take on the Kings. That'll be the last game of their very short three-game road tour.
You wouldn't fucking do that when I was trying to hook you up, man. Big fat nigga, man.
Good ball. Parker kicks to Anderson. Outside, Green. Nails the baby hook.
Well, Well, we know this about Jazz head coach Quinn Snyder. He has a wide range of coaching experience, right? He's coached at the college level, in the minors, over in Europe. And in today's game, I think that breadth of experience is invaluable.
Zafalosha kicks to Burks. Tipped away. Parker with the steal. One-on-one here. It's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
And Parker is just so deceptive on the drive. He just knows how to force the issue down low.
And Tony Parker in his prime, one of the best slashing point guards this league has ever seen. Just an outstanding finisher amidst the tall players. And one season, how about he almost led the league in points in the paint. A surefire Hall of Fame.
He's off the back. And a bit of a down year for Tony Parker in 2017. His lowest three-point percentage in 5 years. Lowest free throw percentage in 9.
Yeah, he'd like to see him hitting threes at a higher clip. The previous couple seasons, he shot it up over 40%. And a great way, I think, to boost his offense, even though he has slowed down a bit.
And he's good on the second.
At least he made one.
And Tony Parker in the 2017 season with the lowest minutes per game average in his career. He was playing so well in the playoffs. I mean, historically well. Then, Greg, as we know, the quad injury in the playoffs.
Yeah, and it's pretty clear that 15-year run he's had as a starter, that window is rapidly closing. But still effective, just no longer the focal point that he once was. And when you've got a big man who can shoot from distance like that, what a huge advantage.
To the wing right side. Leonard sends a screen for Parker. Out to the right wing. The baseline J lands
under
the rim and drops. And Leonard's got his second basket of the night.
Yeah, and from mid-range, Leonard's jump shot is money. It doesn't matter if it's off the dribble or catch and shoot. He never loses his touch.
Mitchell passes to Ingles. Gobert with a screen on Green. Out to the wing. Your rep code is just to Ingles. From the line, San Antonio with the rebound, and this game, the first chance they've had to see Utah.
And we saw how competitive and entertaining the season series was between these two terrific teams last year.
Both these teams are beneficiaries of tremendous coaching. Both have high hopes for the season. See a chess match tonight.
Busted Green, busted.
Rolls it from 20. Mitchell. The Jazz, they lead by a bucket. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, Kevin. Kawhi, you have grown so much offensively throughout your career. What's the focus at that end of the floor?
Just knocking down open shots, my ball handling, making good decisions off the pick and roll, and just try to limit my turnovers.
You've done well so far, Kawhi. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
get the first one.
I'll tell you guys, there's a tenacity to his game that you have to like. DJ never gets lazy out there. He always seems to go full speed.
And he can't hit the
fuck, man.
And missing opportunities here to extend that lead at the free throw line.
And there's the feed to Mitchell. Here's your rep go. He's covered by Anderson. Udo kicks to Zapolosha.
Fuck, man.
Zapolosha's got five.
And you gotta love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of a grind it out game.
Outside, Green. Spurs working the ball around now. Parker with it. Guarded now by Rubio. They kick it out to Green. And it's good on the assist.
Good shit, good shit.
Green's got a second bucket tonight.
And certainly, they are not hesitating, letting it fly from deep here in the second half.
Two for one opportunity here if they want.
And no doubt, Kevin, if I'm them, I go for it.
And Rubio kicks to Mitchell. Here's the screen for Anderson. And that one comes up a bit short.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
How in the hell did I miss that shit, man?
After the basket comes up empty on what might have been an easy play.
Now, here's Rubio. He's got seven. Dish now to Zapolosha. Beyond the arc. With a 7-point lead. Well, they trail by a bunch. Well,
yeah.
Huh. We'll get right back to the action when we return. And now a sneak peek into the huddle with Coach Quinn Snyder. San Antonio starting the fourth quarter. Arthur and Green are the guard set. DJ out there with Rudy Gay. And it's Pertinis in at the five, roaming the paint. Steps back and shoots. That shot missing. And it's Utah the other way. Oklahoma City Thunder will be in town for the next one. And that game is the second of two straight home.
And if that doesn't get too fired up, guys, nothing will.
Right, just with the doctor ordered, huh? Some high-flying antics to narrow the deficit.
Yeah, and an example of why you want to let the game come to you. The opening presented itself, he converted in a big way.
Utah calls timeout.
Yeah, it looks like they tried to shoot their way out of the swamp, and that didn't work. They got to go back and regroup.
Yeah, maybe a new approach, because what they're doing is over some things on the offensive end.
A different look for Utah. Rudy Gobert, who's checked in for Utah. And so it's San Antonio, easily taking this one. This was a very strong showing for him, Greg. Not necessarily a runaway win, but one they'll feel very good about.
And let's face it, anytime you can go on the road and win in the fashion they did, you have to feel good about it. Really an outstanding effort all the way around.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Olden.
Yeah, shit, man.
Alrighty, y'all, this Energy Rock 89 gonna sign out. Go ahead and come back. Make another video later on. See how it goes. Y'all have a good one.